This is the continuation of the negotiation tactics. Number six, and this is the last, communication. In negotiation, communication is the most important tools to capture one party's attention. Fixed communication also one positive apex to become successful or to reach the goal or the target. The tactics are divided into two, such as formal communication and informal communication. In informal communication, the negotiators set the meetings with a specific date, meeting time, and place, bringing out the plan to be tackled during negotiations. While in informal communication, this is the changing of short conversation only through sending of message or telephone calls. This is usually observed when the two parties involved as only want to clarify about the negotiations. There are two types of communication during negotiations. These are verbal communication and nonverbal communication. In verbal communication, the type of communication where the two parties when the two or more parties involved will communicate each other. Nonverbal communication. This is the communication where the people involved must negotiate through their body language or gesture and facial expression. In negotiation, there is also a negotiator. This is the person to be negotiated in one party as a representative in behalf of the management. There are types of negotiators, and these are soft negotiator, hard negotiator, and principal negotiator. In soft negotiator, these people see negotiation as too close to competition, so they choose a gentle style of bargaining. The offers they make are not in their best interest. They yield to another's demand, avoid confrontation, and they maintain good relations with fellow negotiators. In hard negotiators, these are people use continuous strategies to influence utilizing phrase. Example, this is my final offer and take it or leave it. They make threat, are distrustful of others, insist on their position, and apply pressure to negotiate. The last is principled negotiator. This is the individual who bargains, this way seeks integrative solutions, and does so by sidestepping commitment to specific positions. They focus on the problem rather than the intention, motives, and needs of the people involved. With this, a skilled negotiator may serve as an advocate for one party to the negotiation. The advocate attempts to obtain the most favorable outcome possible for the party. Skilled negotiators are also may use a variety of tactics ranging from negotiation. There is also negotiation style. The negotiation style used during a negotiation depends on the context and the interest of the other party. Among the factors, in addition, styles can change over time. Number one of the negotiation style is accommodating. Individuals who enjoy solving the other party's problems and preserving personal relationships. Accommodators are sensitive to the emotional states, body language, and verbal signals of the other parties. Number two is avoiding. Individuals who do not like to negotiate and don't do it unless warranted. When negotiating, avoiders tend to defer and dodge the confrontational aspect of negotiating. However, they may be perceived as tactful and diplomatic. Number three is collaborating. Individuals who enjoy negotiations that involve solving problems in creative ways. Number four is competitive. Negotiators have strong instincts for all aspects of negotiating and are often strategic. Number five, and this is the last, is compromising. Compromising, individuals who are eager to close the deal by doing what is fair and equal for all parties involved in the negotiation. Compromisers can be useful when there is limited time to complete the deal. However, compromisers often unnecessarily rush the negotiation process and make concessions too quickly. The relation of emotion in negotiation is emotion play an important part in the negotiation process. Emotion have the potential to play either a positive or negative role in negotiation. Negative emotion affect as the negative negotiation, and it is positive effect of positive emotions. Positive effect in negotiation, negotiators who are in a positive mood tend to enjoy the interaction more, show less contentious behavior, use less aggressive tactics, and more cooperative strategies. Negative effect in negotiation is negative effect has detrimental effects on various stages in the negotiation process. Although various negative emotions affect negotiation outcomes, there are some problems and hindrances during negotiation. Number one is diehard bargainers, lack of trust. Number two, number three, informational vacuums and negotiators' dilemma. Number four, structural impediments. Number five, spoilers. Six, cultural and gender differences. Seven, communications problem. And the last is the power of dialogue. It is really hard to negotiate to other party. More barriers and hindrances will occur during negotiator. The criteria to be a negotiator or to become successful negotiators are number one, trust, integrity, word of honor, transparency about party interests. All in all, integrity. In my previous job, I am in charge in negotiation regarding the price of scrap. If the price given by scrap buyer is not based in the market price, I am trying to look another buyer to negotiate again, as well as the price of the scrap, like hazardous waste for treatment and the scrap residual waste for final disposal. If the cost is higher, I will try to look also the other treatment company to negotiate again. That is all about the conflict and negotiation. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.